Hello friends, I am Prof.S.S.Kale. Today we are going to see RL series circuit, which is in basic electrical engineering unit number 5, single phase AC circuit. This is a respective diagram, that is a resistance and inductance are connected in series across a supply voltage V, where applied voltage V is the RMS value of the voltage. The current flowing through the RL series circuit is the RMS value of the current. The drop across the resistance is VR and drop across the inductance is VL. Here VR is equal to I, which is the current flowing through the resistance, and R, that is IR drop according to the Ohm's law. The nature of the current I will be in phase with I. The voltage drop across resistance, that is VR, is equal to I into R. The nature of the current will be in phase with voltage V. Similarly, VL is equal to I into XL, where XL is nothing but what? It is inductive reactance. The nature of the current I for this voltage VL will be leading V by 90 degrees. Now, based upon these two conclusions, we can draw the phasor diagram. So now, here the current I is a common factor. Current I is a common factor. So with respect to the current I, we are going to draw the nature of the voltage VR and voltage VL. So I will take the reference as current I. So based upon the first equation, we have written that what? I will be in phase with V, or I will say that this is this VR, and here that is VL. So according to the first statement, VR will be in phase with I. The second equation, that is VL is equal to I into XL, where I will be the case. So VL will be leading current I by 90 degrees. The resultant voltage vector V is nothing but what? Phasor addition of VR and VL. So we will do the vector addition for VR and VL. So we will draw the parallelogram. So this is nothing but what? Vector addition, and the resultant vector V is nothing but what? It is V, that is applied voltage V. The angle between this voltage and current is nothing but what? It is phi. It is called as the power factor angle. Based upon this, this is your phasor diagram. Based upon this diagram, we can draw the voltage triangle, where voltage triangle can be drawn as this is VR, which is my reference. 90 degree apart, it will be VL, and the phasor addition of VR and VL, it is nothing but what? V, where V is I into R, VL is I into XL, and this V is I into impedance Z. We are going to derive the equation for impedance Z. This is your angle phi. The impedance triangle can be drawn similarly using the same conclusion, that is, this will be your base R. Based upon this equation, VR is equal to I into R. The imaginary part, which is XL, will be in the positive Y axis, and the resultant vector is nothing but what? It is your Z. So we can say that Z is nothing but what? It is the phasor addition of resistance R and inductance XL, where this corner angle is your angle phi. Based upon this equation, I can write it as V bar, which is the vector quantity, which is nothing but what? VR bar plus VL bar. I can also write that is magnitude of voltage V is under root of real part square plus imaginary part square, that is VR square plus VL square, that is equal to under root of, instead of VR, I can write it as IR the whole square, and VL as I XL the whole square. If I take the current I common outside the bracket, I can write it as capital V is equal to I under root of R square plus XL square. Therefore, capital V is equal to I into Z. So, Z is equal to under root of R square plus XL square. The angle phi is the power factor angle. So from the impedance triangle, the corner angle phi is nothing but what I can write it as tan inverse of imaginary part, that is XL, upon real part, that is R. So angle phi is power factor angle. Also we can write the power factor, that is cos phi. So based upon the trigonometric concept, cos phi is nothing but what? Adjacent upon hypotenuse. Here your adjacent is nothing but what? It is your resistance R, and hypotenuse is your capital Z, that is impedance. So power factor can be derived from the impedance angle, that is R by Z. Similarly, we can also derive the formula for the active power, reactive power, and the apparent power from the above case. So this axis, which is your real axis, it is called as true power, that is capital P, is equal to I square R. Or also we can write as capital P, that is active power capital P, is equal to VI cos phi. There is one imaginary power which is called as reactive power, which is denoted by capital Q, is given by I square XL, or capital Q is equal to VI sine phi. The resultant is nothing but what? It is denoted by capital S, that is equal to V into I. Or I can also write it as capital S is equal to I square into Z. This is called as your apparent power. So summarizing, I can write active power capital P is equal to V I cos phi, reactive power capital Q is equal to V I sine phi, apparent power capital S is equal to V I only. The unit of capital P, that is active power, is given by watts. It is a true power, or we can also say that it is a real power. Similarly, the reactive power capital Q is nothing but what? VI sine phi. This sine phi is nothing but, it is a reactive component. So I will write it as, that is V for voltage, A for ampere, and this reactive is denoted by small r, that is VAR. And the apparent power capital S is nothing but, simply nothing but what? It is a product of voltage and current. So unit will be volt amp, that is VA. Now, after this we can draw the final concept, that is the waveform for this series RL circuit. So, if you take the voltage as a reference, I can write it as the instantaneous voltage V is equal to Vm sine omega t. Vm sine omega t. So that is Vm is nothing but what? Maximum voltage. It is varying sinusoidal in nature, omega t. This is the reference value. The instantaneous current small I can be written as Im sine omega t minus phi. So referring to the previous case, that is we have drawn the phasor diagram for the voltage and current. The angle between voltage and current was what? Angle phi. So this, the current I will lag the voltage by some angle phi. So lagging current is represented by minus phi. So keeping this equation into mind, I will draw the waveforms. So first I will draw the waveform for the voltage. Why? Because we have taken it as a reference. So it is varying sinusoidally. So this is the voltage waveform, this is V, and I have to draw the current waveform, which will lag by angle phi. So here I will say this is my lagging angle phi. From this point my current waveform will start. So it will be somewhat like this, and this is your current waveform, that is I. So taking here, it is nothing but what? This. Thank you.
So guys, stay innovative, stay hungry, subscribe the channel, press the bell icon. I will get back to you very soon with new stuff. Till then, bye-bye.